it's not easy task. It needs a lot of water. So you can bring back, not an individual, you can bring back the whole society and put it together to continue its journey. So we should really, there's a big, huge mix, you said, between these two things. Our brother, I think he has some intervention.
Yes.
I will give you that. Yes.
The two things. Number one, the ayah you were reciting, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرْ مَا بِقَوْمٍ. Allah is telling us that there is a protection, and protection means everything is there, but you have to search for yourself.
Exactly.
If you don't, I'm not going to give it to you. It is there. Yes. I have created everything.
Yes.
So that's one thing. And second thing is that وَالسَّمَاءَ وَالطَّارِقِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الطَّارِقُ طَارِقُ النَّجْمُ الثَّاقِبُ. All these what we talked about can be possible. Allah is giving us, in my view, a definition of najm.
Yeah.
What kind of najm you have to be? You can put a candle, it will give you one type of light. You can put a 60 watt bulb or 100 watt bulb, and the bigger you are, the bigger light you have, the bigger influence you will have.
Oh, so
first we have to create that kind of light in ourselves, and only then we should be able to, like you said, there are so many things coming your way.
Mm-hmm.
The bigger and the socket we are, we can move them
exactly.
Away.
It's excellent. We can combine both ideas.
I mean, this is the Quran, basically, this is the hope that Najee was talking about.
Right.
That even for those who are trying to cover up,
right.
Quran is saying, يُرِيدُونَ لِيُطْفِئُ نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ وَاللَّهُ مُتِمُّ نُورِهِمْ. These people who are, the Quran is calling them Al-Kafirin, they are really trying their best.
We'll leave,
cover up and extinguish that light, whatever.
Yeah, and also, you know, put it in a daily example. If I'm telling somebody I have heard this and I think it is like this, and I, you know, I'm conveying the message, would not have such an influence where I'm fully aware of and I'm clear about the message, and then I'm talking about it. You know, there is a difference between the two messages I'm conveying. If I'm not clear myself and I have heard from somebody and I'm talking, compared to I know exactly it is coming from the Quran and I'm clear about the message myself.
Yeah.
With the reference.
How we make an-nahar happen?
With the reference. Exactly.
And also is the sun, right?
Right.
We have najm. Let's take the universe level, the image.
Absolutely.
There is najm, there is the star, there is, you know, it's not just, it's najm. There is the sun. And when we talk about the sun, we say how we put it in a different way. والنهاري إلى جلاه. It's not the opposite. It's not the same. But anyway, there is a star and there is نهار. There is day because there is a star. And there is a new era. Brother is talking about the new era. But you brought what type of نجم you will need.
Yes.
Is a نجم الثاقب. Is really piercing star. You need that ability to change or to bring life to new era. It's not easy task. It's not fatwa. Airing fatwa. There's no way with this paradigm of fatwa that we spend millions to bring it to the Ummah is going to change this world. Forget about it. Without that najm thaqib, as you said, there's no new era, as he said. How the Quran described Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was one, the best man who changed the world as najm thaqib. Remind either that ayah, please.
سراجا منيرا.
Translated. أو الآية. Please.
إنا أرسلناك شاهدا مبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. القرآن called that the same time الشمس
سراج قمر منير.
سراج. So I mean he gave Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم the same description like the sun.
He was the, also the piercing.
So there is sun coming out from Medina.
Exactly.
And it has still affecting us,
yeah.
Giving us light. Till now, the same way, how far is the sun, but it touches everyone on this planet.
Yes.
It's
beautiful,
beautiful,
beautiful
description.
Yeah. Sorry, brother, we took a lot of your half hour things. Maybe you can.
Inshallah. Yeah, the whole idea is, again, the hope. We really need and if it is not done by us, Allah Ta'ala will bring another group will take care of it. Subhanallah, Allah, when you take about al-hafaz, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said through
Prophet Hud عليه السلام. وإن تولى Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring, if you divert, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will bring other people, and this will not harm him, it will harm you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَفِيظٍ. You see, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَفِيظٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is protecting everything. He will protect the journey of the human being. But if we don't do it ourselves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring another group that will do it. So it is going to happen. But the question is, are we going to be part of that privilege, of that duty, of that honor to be part of the change, leading the change? And that's what I would like really to leave you with.
And how big we are as human being in the eyes of revelation. Means imagine that human being, you can be that piercing star. So yeah. how Quran sees the human being, and so beautiful. But anyway, if we write day and night about this surah, we're not going to end. So we took 15 minutes from our brother time.
Thank you very much.
Like Allah.